Now let's look at this small question. It's a 2x2 matrix for us to understand how to find the inverse of this. So I'll do that using the elementary row operations that we have seen. And the reason why I'm taking a 2x2 matrix is to keep it simple, just to make sure that you understand what is the method, and then you can extend this to 3x3 matrix as well. So what I first do is I just write the elements as it is. And then I separate these by writing an identity matrix of the same order, right? So this is a 2x2 matrix. So this is a 2x2 matrix. So this will be a 2x2 identity matrix, right? Now this is your R1 and this is your R2. Now your goal is to make sure that your left hand side looks something like this, right? And your right hand side, automatically, if you are able to create this sort of a left hand side, your right hand side is itself your inverse. And if you are not able to create this, then I can say that the inverse does not exist. So let's see what we can do here. So there is a 1 here. The 1 here is already present. You have to make sure that this 3 becomes 0. So what you do is you multiply first row by 3 times and you subtract the second row from this, and basically you replace second row with this. So your second row changes to 3 times the first row minus the second row. So this becomes 1, 2. The first row remains as it is. The second row is now 3 into, this is 3 into 1 minus 3. This is 3 into 2 minus 4. This is 3 into 1 minus 0. And this is 3 into 1. This is 3 into 0 minus 1. Right, that's something. This is how your second row will now look like. So your new matrix is somewhat like this: 1, 0, and then this is first row is anyways as it is. The second row is 6 minus 4, 2, and this is your 3, and this is 0 minus 1, minus 1. Let me just verify the calculations. Yeah, so it's fine. Now what your goal is, to make sure that this element here becomes 0, because you can see a 0 here, so you have to try to make sure that this becomes a 0. So my next step would be that I would change the first row to first row minus second row, right? Because you don't want to disturb this 1 as well, you want to make sure that this is as it is. So and 1 minus 0 will keep it 1. So this will become a 1 minus 0 1, a 2 minus 2 0. This will be a 1 minus 3, a minus 2. This will be a 0. And the second row will remain as it is. Now, the final thing that you have to do is you have to make this 2 as 1. So you have to make sure this is 1. So what you do is, finally, you will divide the second row by 2 and replace that in your second row. So I'm just, all these things that you see here, all this, this is an elementary row operation. This is an elementary row operation, this is an elementary row operation, right? So with this, what you finally get is first row is as it is, and your second row becomes 0, R2 by 2 is 1, and this is 3 by 2, this is minus half. Now you have successfully created an identity matrix on this side, so that I can say inverse exists as far as this problem is concerned, and this particular matrix, these 4 elements, they themselves are your inverse. So the inverse, A inverse, I can say is minus 2, 0, 3 by 2 and minus half. That's the method. You can always extend this to a 3 by 3 matrix using similar row operations, and you can find the inverse of a matrix. Let's look at the second way to find the inverse.